Cabinet will decide today whether Auckland will remain at alert level 3 or if restrictions will ease. Finance Minister Grant Robertson says for the most part, Auckland businesses have coped well with the lockdown. Political reporter Joe Moyer spoke to Mr. Robertson and started by asking whether it's possible Auckland will move to level 2, but travel restrictions would remain.
Oh, I'm not going to get into the range of options that we're looking at. I mean, we have an alert level framework that I think is pretty clear and people can understand. If there need to be specific tweaks to that, those are decisions that we'll make. But I'm not going to get into speculating about that. We obviously are concerning ourselves with the impact that this is having on Auckland and Aucklanders particularly. You know, those level 3 restrictions have certainly, as again the Prime Minister said, delivered in terms of, you know, making sure we have kept control of this particular cluster because of, you know, not having people gathering in schools or churches or in shopping malls. That's helped us. So, you know, that's a factor, but we recognise the impact that has on Aucklanders and Auckland businesses. So we're going to continue to look at all of those issues together.
Because how much damage has the last couple of weeks done to Auckland, and how much damage will there be if it needs to extend beyond Wednesday? And what are you looking at specific to Auckland to address that?
Yeah, I think the feedback I've had is that for the most part, people can cope with a 2 week period of these kinds of restrictions. They can manage. We've stepped up with the wage subsidy scheme, which means people can get, you know, payments for this period of time, and businesses, while not happy about it, are able to manage it. Clearly, the longer things go on, the more challenging it will get, particularly for the businesses who either can't operate at all or are operating in a very restricted form. Bear in mind, you know, there are still a large number of businesses operating at close to full capacity during this period, in the construction industry and infrastructure and so on, and so that's they're coping relatively well. In terms of what more would happen, I've been upfront about the fact that were there to be an extension to the restrictions, we would also extend the wage subsidy scheme for a period if it was a brief continuation. So that's in our back pocket should that be needed.
And what about campaigning? It's obviously on hold at the moment. And, you know, if we are in a situation on Wednesday night where Auckland comes down to level 2 and the rest of the country is level 2 or level 1, is that a green light for political parties to, you know, with social distancing in mind, kind of get back to the campaign trail as such?
Well, I think that's up to each party. In terms of the Labor Party, we've, you know, certainly in the Auckland area, suspended the campaign because it's pretty challenging to do that under level 3. Around the rest of the country, there are, you know, campaigning activities underway, although not some of the face-to-face things like door knocking and so on. So all parties are able to adapt, I think, to that, undertake the activities that are appropriate for the area. But under level 2, around the country, there has been campaigning, and you would expect that if Auckland were to move to level 2 as well.
That's Finance Minister Grant Robertson speaking to our political reporter, Joe Moyer.